They are beautiful.
Hello, art family, and thank you to all the new subscribers. I decided to do this demonstration of a local Thai restaurant my wife and I have been going to a lot lately. I start out with a pencil sketch. I try to find places where pieces of the architecture meet up in space, and then I can get a couple of the angles that I need to build a perspective grid. Most of the perspective lines are arbitrarily drawn. I'll kind of get one angle and my eye line that's flat, of course, and then I just sort of, you know, arbitrarily build a slightly sloping line all the way up. I'm getting a little bit carried away. I should keep it a little bit more loose than I am right now, just to make sure I'm getting the major shapes that I'm trying to draw and paint. For this one, I'm trying to focus more on the light, so I'm less concerned about the specifics of the detailed rendering on the drawing, and I'm more concerned with capturing the way the light at the end of the day was just touching the top of the building, and everything else was cast in shadow. I pre-wet the sky to get a smooth gradient, and then I used some cobalt blue to the left and yellow ochre with a little bit of cadmium medium to get a brighter yellow towards the other end that I try to taper into a lighter, almost white as it goes off the page and closer towards the sun. I'm pre-wetting the whole page because one of the things I noticed was there's a very smooth transition from warm light on the top of the building to cool light that is cast with a lot of purples, and I'm trying to vary my cool shadows across everything with ultramarine blue and burnt sienna, so I'm getting a richer shadow out of the complements of blue and orange together. I'm trying to take this time with the underpainting to sort of lock in my value structure for the direction I want to take this sketch. There are some areas that are pretty much the white of the page, and I'm going to leave them the white of the page to exaggerate the strength of the light. Places on the windows where they are reflecting the light, and sometimes people will use masking fluid. I've seen that done a fair amount, and I've used it before, but it usually is just, it's more of a headache, in my opinion, than worth. I'm keeping the saturation low on the trees in the distance behind the buildings. That way, as I put in the darker values in the foreground and the richer, deeper colors in the foreground, it will help to push those trees further back in space and give a sense of depth in the image. I'm trying to do a similar thing with this four-square house and the four-square house behind it, which is that both of them will lose some detail as they go further and further in space, and they'll also have more water in the mix, so that will lower the saturation of the colors that I'm putting down and push them back. Also, in areas where I'm getting some rich blues that are more cobalt blue, I'm trying to throw in the curveball of some cadmium orange and a little bit of kind of yellow ochre, just to get this dance back and forth between warm and cool. My main concern with this image was not so much a detailed rendering of what I was looking at, and was more about the light, and because of that, to me, it was more about the relationships of the warms and cools. So I kind of wanted to exaggerate the strength of the warms and the cools so that the whole image is more of a value study of the light effect that's happening, but trying to play with the relationships of the warms and the cools and how I can push those to enhance the kind of interest and appeal of the different colors that I'm seeing. I guess I say that to say the actual colors of what I was looking at didn't really interest me as much or concern me that much as the warm and cool relationships. and finding those places in the shadow that the cool light was getting reflected so strongly and getting such a nice rich blue, and places on the undersides, underplanes. You can see on this, on the under part of the porch before it gets to the shadow, and on the underplanes of the soffit ventilation underneath where the roof overhangs. All these downward facing planes, I tried to push the warmth of the light that's bouncing off the ground and off the roof, porch roof, and bouncing up into those downward facing planes. You can kind of see now that the colors and the values that I'm putting down now on the actual restaurant and the places in the foreground, I'm using a much heavier hand, maybe a little bit too heavy of a hand in some parts, to communicate those colors, making those colors more saturated, more intense, making the values more intense, just to add more appeal and more visual interest to the object in the foreground, or the object that I want the viewer to look at and focus their attention on. I'm continuing to progress across the image and lock in my value structure, and also find those planes, the areas where light is bouncing and which areas are warm and which areas are cool. But I'm also trying to use the paint to correct the drawing, in a sense, places where I didn't quite get it right in the drawing, and I'm noticing now, comparing locations of places and pieces of architecture that are maybe misaligned or not correct. I'm trying to use the paint and the value structure to correct that. Again, I'm not very concerned with the specific rendering of the drawing as much as I am the light effect, but I do want to give the sense that it's an actual space, an actual area that you could walk into or feel like you could be inside of this image. So there has to be some accuracy in the drawing and in the light to give that sense of telescoping, you know, when you're looking at the image, that it sort of draws you in or makes you feel like you could walk into the image. I threw down a very heavy-handed, rough shadow for the cars, mainly because there's a lot of light being bounced off the cars, so I was trying to get a sense of strong blue light, so that on the areas where the paint is thinner, you'll get some of that blue shining up through it. You can see there's a couple trouble spots where I had wet areas touching wet areas, and those areas blossomed into the other areas. One of the best tools you can have with watercolor is to learn to kind of let go of those accidents. You can try to correct it with your finger or push it, you know, adjust it with a thirsty brush to suck up some of the mistake you made, but you're really better off just letting it go and moving on. If you get the value structure pretty close to accurate and the warms and cool relationships are all working within a correct range, little mistakes and little things aren't really noticeable, and in fact they kind of add a sort of flavor or seasoning to the image. You know, happy accidents, I guess. I've talked about doing trees in another video, and I find it really helps. I learned it, I think, from Tom Schaller. I think it was in one of his tutorial demos. He talked about holding the brush by the very end so that you get a very loose, organic feel. So what I'll usually do is get a dry brush with color on it, and then use the side of the brush sort of, you know, smushed and pushed around to get a very loose texture of leaves. They give more the sense, the feeling of leaves, and not so much the specific drawing of leaves. And then I'll hold the brush on the end, and then so you get a more organic swing and organic taper to the branches. Some people go nuts with the branches. Like David Bellamy is one of my favorite artist to watch and especially to listen to talk when he talks about painting watercolor, and in like his APV films are outstanding and adventurous and interesting. But one thing he does is he goes nuts with the detail on the trees. He always does these very detailed branches. The trees sort of, they look a little bit like if you see a diagram of blood vessels, you know, outstretched. I'm not as concerned with branches in my sketches. I kind of just like to give a very vague sense of trees. For me, I find treating trees very loosely makes them feel more like trees in space and less like an architectural object that would, you know, warrant some attention. I'm coming back with white gouache to bring back some of the light and try to punch some of the areas where I wanted a little more strength and a little more detail. So that's going to be it for this demonstration of our local Thai restaurant in my neighborhood. I hope you got something from it. Of course, I'm always here to talk shop in the comment section if you have any questions or stuff you want in future videos. And I guess I'll see you in the next one. Happy sketching!